同学们好，今天我们来学习第91课 Lesson 91 Poor Ian。 在今天的课文当中呢， Ian 的邻居们在谈论他， Ian's neighbors are talking about him。 好，一起来看课文，并且回答这样一个问题。 Who wanted to sell the house? 谁想卖房子？
Has Ian sold his house yet?
Yes, he has.He sold it last week.
Has he moved to his new house yet?
No, not yet. He's still here. He's going to move tomorrow.
When? Tomorrow morning?
No, tomorrow afternoon. I'll miss him. He's always been a good neighbor.
He's a very nice person. We'll all miss him. When will the new people move into this house?
I think that they'll move in the day after tomorrow.
Will you see Ian today, Jenny?
Yes, I will.
Please give him my regards.Poor Ian. He didn't want to leave this house.
No, he didn't want to leave. But his wife did.
现在请大家回答这个问题。Who wanted to sell the house? Ian's wife. 原来想卖房子的并不是 Ian 本人，而是他的妻子。好，下面我们一起来看本课中的关键词和词组。Keywords and expressions. Move, miss, neighbor, person, people, poor. Poor 还有一个意思就是贫穷的。一起来看本课中的主要语言点。Has he moved to his new house yet? No, not yet. 他已经迁入新居了吗？还没有呢。Not yet 是一种省略的说法。如果完整的说就是 No, he hasn't moved to his new house yet. He's still here. He's going to move tomorrow. 他现在还在这儿呢。Still, 仍然。He's going to move tomorrow. 他明天搬家。其中的一个邻居说 I'll miss him. I'll 意思是 I will 或者是 I shall 表示将来，我将会想念他的。另外 miss 这个词在这个句子当中意思是想念。再来看一个例句。I miss home very much. 我很想家。但是 miss 还有另外一个意思就是错过。来看 I missed the train yesterday. 我昨天错过火车了。邻居们称赞 Ian 说 He has always been a good neighbor. 他一直都是一个好邻居。因为 Ian 在这儿住了很长时间，所以邻居们说他一直如何如何，用了现在完成时 He has always been。 是的，邻居们说他 He's a very nice person. We'll all miss him. 他是一个很好的人，我们大家都会想念他的。 Will 相当于 We will 或者 We shall， 是一般将来时。 All用在三者或者三者以上，如果是两个人，我们就要用 both 这个词。比如 My husband and I will both miss him. 我和我的丈夫都会想念他的。人们又关心新邻居什么时候搬进来，所以他们问道 When will the new people move into this house? 新邻居什么时候搬进来？因为搬进来也是将要发生的事情，所以用了一般将来时，用了助动词 will 加上动词的原形。Move into this house， 搬到这所房子里来。I think that they'll move in the day of tomorrow. The day of tomorrow， 后天，所以仍然用了一般将来时 will 加上动词原形。Move in 就相当于 move into this house。请大家注意这段话当中的两个词 person 人，这是一个单数的概念， people 人们 这是一个复数的概念。来看两个例句。She's the right person for this job. 她是做这项工作的合适人选。There are a lot of people in the park. 公园里有许多人。那么单数概念的时候用的是 person, 而指许多人的时候用的是 people。Will you see Ian today, Jenny? Yes, I will. 你今天会碰到 Ian 吗？是的，我会。如果回答是我不会，那么就是 No, I won't. Won't 是 will not 的缩写形式。见到 Ian 要做什么呢？这位邻居说，请代我向他问好。Please give him my regards. Give somebody somebody's regards. 意思是代某人向其他人问好。来看这个例句，请代我们向你的祖母问好。Please give our regards to your grandmother. 一位邻居很同情 Ian, 他说 Poor Ian, he didn't want to leave this house. 可怜的 Ian, 他不想离开这座房子。另一位邻居表示同意，他是怎么说的呢？No, he didn't want to leave, but his wife did. 他是不想离开，但是他的妻子想。这句话是对上一句话的证实。由于这句话 he didn't want to leave this house 是一种否定的说法，所以在证实的时候要根据事实来说。那么翻成中文的时候呢，我们要说是的，他不想离开。来看这种说法。He didn't go to school last week, did he? 他上星期没去上学，是吗？这是一个反义疑问句。如果他没有去上学，根据事实回答就是 No, he didn't. 但是在翻成汉语的时候，我们要根据上文来说，是的，他没有去上学。如果他去上学了，回答是 Yes, he did. 但是在翻成汉语的时候，我们要说不，他去上学了。这点请大家注意。在学习了课文的主要语言点之后，我们来总结一下本课的基本句型。我们学到的主要是一般将来时。一般将来时是用来描述将要发生的事情的，它的基本构成是 will 加上动词原形，在第一人称的单数和复数，也就是 I 或者 we 的后面还可以用 shall 这个词，不过在现代英语中 shall 已经很少用了。好，一起来看基本句型。 What will, when will? What will you do tomorrow? I'll go to the country. 你明天将要做什么？我明天会到乡下去。 When will you leave? I'll leave at 7 o'clock. 你什么时候出发？我7点钟出发。一般将来时通常和表示将来的时间状语连用，比如说 tomorrow 明天 at 7 o'clock 7点钟，这个 7 o'clock 指的是明天的7点钟。好，下面我们再来看一遍课文，请大家跟读，并且注意邻居们是怎样描述将要发生的事情的。
Has Ian sold his house yet?
Yes, he has. He sold it last week.
Has he moved to his new house yet?
No, not yet. He's still here. He's going to move tomorrow.
When? Tomorrow morning?
No, tomorrow afternoon. I'll miss him. He's always been a good neighbor.
He's a very nice person.We'll all miss him. When will the new people move into this house?
I think that they'll move in the day after tomorrow.
Will you see Ian today, Jenny?
Yes, I will.
Please give him my regards. Poor Ian.He didn't want to leave this house.
No, he didn't want to leave, but his wife did.
下面我们进入句型训练， 来练习一下在不同的场景下如何使用一般将来时。Lesson 92 When will rain tomorrow? When will it rain? It will rain tomorrow. Snow the day of tomorrow. When will it snow? It'll snow the day of tomorrow. Get up at 11. When will he get up? He'll get up at 11. Finish work tomorrow night. When will he finish work? He'll finish work tomorrow night. Have a holiday the day of tomorrow. When will you have a holiday? We'll have a holiday the day of tomorrow. Drive home this afternoon. When will they drive home? They'll drive home this afternoon. Have a haircut the day of tomorrow in the morning. 后天早晨。When will you have a haircut? I'll have a haircut the day of tomorrow in the morning. Telephone me tonight. When will she telephone me? She'll telephone you tonight. Pack his bags tomorrow. When will he pack his bags?He'll pack his bags tomorrow. Sweep the floor tomorrow. When will she sweep the floor? She'll sweep the floor tomorrow. Repair my car tomorrow. When will they repair your car? They'll repair my car tomorrow.Make an appointment tomorrow. When will he make an appointment? He'll make an appointment tomorrow.
今天我们学习了如何描述将要发生的事情。在句型训练中，我们用 when 来提问，是想让大家了解一般将来时常常和表示将来的时间状语连用。那么在课后练习时呢，大家可以用我们学过的其他的疑问词，比如 what, where, why, how, how long 等等来提问。好了，今天的课就到这儿了。Thank you and goodbye.